Fascinating. The Weather Channel in the news. Why? Because they said the N-word. Let's put it up full mass. They are apologizing for their use of the N-word appearing in an on-screen graphic during a local weather segment. Hello, Des Moines. This is your weather, my N-words. Local on the 8s. Now, just imagine if you were watching the news in this moment and you saw this flash across your television screen, you would be outraged, right? So after journalist Matthew Keyes posted a screenshot of the image online, the Weather Channel issued a statement on Facebook. Here's the statement from the Weather Channel. A graphic during the Weather Channel cable network's Local on the 8s presentation in Des Moines last evening included a racial slur. Okay. We removed this graphic as soon as we learned of it. This did not originate with us, and we are in the process of investigating it further. We apologize to our viewers. Now, when they say this did not originate with us, you know, you kind of scratch your head. It's on your channel, it's presented on your network, and it's a graphic that comes from the Weather Channel. And this was an interesting explanation, but this may actually be connected to, let's say, a disgruntled former employee. It doesn't help that the Weather Channel's owner, good brother, media mogul Byron Allen, he acquired the channel in 2018. Once again, there's speculation online that this incident was called by rogue employee or former employee of a local affiliate station. There are supposed to be checks, so things like this do not happen. I've worked in broadcasting for a number of years, and the staff around me, they've worked in broadcasting. Typically, there are protocols to stop something like this from going on air. I don't know if the protocols were in place, or maybe the person was able to bypass those protocols, but there's a reason this does not happen normally. And naturally, I do not believe that the CEO of the Weather Channel is racist. I think Byron Allen is a stand-up guy who actually fights against systemic racism, especially in the arena of media. All right, Ben, what are your thoughts on this?
Yeah, I mean, like, it's just one of those things where, like, you know, it could be one of two things, but those two things are pretty much the same thing. And this is where I think people need to understand that how this is important. A lot of people on the internet are sort of like irony poisoned, and they think it's funny to be racist, right? They're being racist is a meme, as a joke, right? But it's not a joke. It's never a joke, and it's not a meme. Like, the thing is like, this is just all over the place. So, like, whether or not it was a disgruntled employee trying to get people in trouble, or whether or not it was somebody memeing, it's kind of irrelevant, because that, like, you know, being a fascist for the lols is a trend that really just leads to people just being fascist. People voting for Donald Trump as a joke voted for Donald Trump, right? And so that's the reality where, like, we're spiraling. And like, to the people who are watching that, they must have woke up thinking, like, did I wake up in a parallel universe? Did I go back in time? Like, what happened? You know, what has happened here? And it's just like one of these just terrifying realities of, like, how far things are accelerating in the wrong direction right now.
Yeah, well said.